In our next story, we're going to take a look at the restoration of old books. Norris Bookbinding is the largest book repair and Bible restoration company in the nation. And while they breathe new life into old books, its owners are trying to figure out how to breathe new life into a dying art form.
Norris Bookbinding is a real specialist in rebinding and restoring old Bibles and old books. We're probably the most diversified bookbinding company in the world. We bind everything from newspapers, we bind still bind courthouse records, we bind all types of periodicals.
We've been binding Billboard magazines probably for 30 years. They'll send us each issue every month, and over a period of a year's time, we'll bind, I think, 4 volumes and combine those books and send those to Billboard magazine.
Most of the work we do now is kind of tapered down from what we used to do. We used to do a lot of National Geographic, Reader's Digest. We do a lot of children's books, old recipe books. You'd be surprised at the old books that Grandma handed down to her. Their daughter, and they send them in here now, they want to preserve them.
We bind a lot of school textbooks because we can bind them for a lot cheaper than they could buy new ones. Just about anything in a way of book binding a book, you know, we do from every kind of book, you know, from funny books to Bibles.
Here at Norris Bookbinding, our primary thing is rebinding old Bibles. We repair over 600 a month. We're considered the world's largest Bible restoration company because of the number of books that we bind each month. As far as new bindings, we don't do a lot of new bindings, but restoration-wise, we probably do more than any other bindery in the nation.
We're proud to be able to take one like this and turn it into something nice. H.H. Norris started Norris Bookbinding in Greenwood, Mississippi in 1947. Mr. Norris had experience and had the idea of Bible binding. He knew a Bible is a very sentimental thing to a person, but for different reasons, someone gave it to them, but it's because it's been in the family for such a long time, nobody wants to lose their family Bible that they had so many years, so it's irreplaceable. Now, you can go buy all the books and things, but you can't replace that Bible if it gets lost or torn up. People drop them out of a car and trucks run over them, cars run over. But one of the biggest things we have problems with now, and I got a Bible here now, is one that dogs get a hold of. And they eat up part of the corners and things, you know, and we have to try to get that, mend that. But bindings such as canvas covers and it goes on those books.
And they don't want to get rid of that Bible. It means a lot to them. They've had them for 50 years, a lot of them. And they can refer back to those notes. And they can buy a new Bible a lot of times cheaper than we can fix one. But it's not the same.
And I'm gonna see if I can put this back on there.
The Bible business makes up about 95% of our business now because of the computers taking away so much from us, from hardback binding, because they don't look in a book anymore, they look on a screen.
We used to do a lot more newspaper and library binding, magazine bindings than we do now. And I think one of the reasons why that has dropped off is because of the digital technology today. Many people can receive a magazine or a newspaper through the internet, read it on their phone, and I think that's one reason why we've lost a lot of the book business that we had years ago.
Now, we've had to make changes in order to survive. A lot of the binders have gone out of business that does hardback binding, but they all tell us that we got a niche because we do the Bibles. And they say, y'all will never go out of business, you know, because there's not a lot of people that know how to bind the Bible.
Well, we're still, I would say, the antique kind of binding people. You go in these big factories, they got them where they run them books and things through a machine, they come out on it then, they done. But we do so many odd and end, we don't hardly have two alike at one time. So everything's hand done. You handle every book, you handle every Bible, by itself.
And we get Bibles from every state in the United States and some foreign countries. Some of these Bibles are in pretty bad shape, just like, for instance, this old family Bible right here. That's the way they look in when they come in. And some people think that something like that just can't be repaired, you know. But we can take that, and it's going to take some time to get all those pages straight.
The condition of the pages, we can't. Only God could perform a miracle and make those pages new, and we have a hard time making people believe that sometimes because they paid this money to get a brand new cover, but the inside hadn't changed. But we can repair the pages if they will stand a mending tape, you know, it won't break.
The inside is still old, same information inside, but by putting a new cover on it and restoring that, then you've preserved it for another lifetime.
My brother Johnny and I own Norris Bookbinding Company now. We've been here for about 120 years if you combine our time. My brother and I got involved in it at a real early age when we were in high school and was encouraged to stay in it. And I started to work here at the age of 15 years old. And a couple of years after that, my brother Johnny started here.
So we've been happy in here. We've worked hard all our lives, and we're not getting any younger. It's too good a business just to let it play out. So what we want to do is get enough for our family in here and the people that's been here so long. And try to keep this place going, because since 1947 is a long time.
We're not just setting the woods on fire, but we're still hanging on, and we give all the credit really to God for blessing us. I mean, he really has, and I think binding his book is one reason.
God has blessed us a lot. And we're hoping that we can pass it on to some of our family, and it just won't die out, because I think there'll always be a place for Bible rebinding.
Thanks for joining us. If you like what you see, subscribe to Mississippi Public Broadcasting. Till next time, I'll be seeing you on Mississippi Roads.
Mississippi.